Here we're going to discuss inverse tangent and inverse cotangent. So here at the very top I've graphed the tangent function, and I can see that this function is not one-to-one, that is, it doesn't pass the horizontal line test. So if we're looking at the function f of x is tangent, that I can see, well, first of all, the domain, right? The domain is x cannot be an odd multiple of pi over 2. And the range is, of course, negative infinity to infinity. Now, the function we just mentioned is not one-to-one, and that means, that implies, that there's no inverse. So what we're going to do is we're going to restrict the domain of tangent. So we're going to look at a new function. So let's write this down. This is going to be tangent, restricted tangent. Now, nobody really says restricted. You have to know that it's restricted by the domain that's given. So what we're going to do is we're going to restrict the domain to be from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. And this function is 1-to-1, right? It definitely passes the horizontal line test, so it has an inverse. And the range of this function, of course, is still negative infinity to infinity. So when we can write down, first of all, that this function is 1-to-1, and that implies it has an inverse. And when we find that inverse, like we found inverse sine and inverse cosine, we are going to write that in the following way. F inverse is inverse tangent. Okay? Now what's important is that the domain of this function is negative infinity to infinity, and the range is from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. So we just created the inverse, not of tangent, but of restricted tangent. Now, people will just refer to this as inverse tangent, and you have to know they're really talking about restricted tangent. Now, the most important thing here is that the range is from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. That is, that the output is an angle in this interval. Now, we can also play the same game and create inverse cotangent. Let's do that now. So at the top here is the graph of cotangent, and I've graphed two cycles of cotangent. And once again, I can see, of course, that function is not one-to-one. So the domain of cotangent, recall, is, well, everything, that is, x can be anything except for a multiple of pi. And the range is negative infinity to infinity. And the problem, of course, is that it's not one-to-one. And so that implies there's no inverse. So what we're going to do is we're going to restrict the domain such that the function is one-to-one. And here's the restriction. Our new domain for restricted cotangent. So we have cotangent, but restricted. The domain of that is going to be, well, from 0 to pi. And the range is still going to be negative infinity to infinity. And this function is 1-to-1. And so that implies that it has an inverse. And that inverse function we're going to denote in the following way. F inverse is the inverse of cotangent. And the domain of this function is just like inverse tangent. The domain is negative infinity to infinity. And the range here is from 0 to pi. So this is what we mean by inverse cotangent. Okay, so now the question is, now that we have these inverse functions, how do you go about evaluating them? And the key thing to remember, of course, is mainly their range. That's kind of where the trickiness lies. Let's see an example of how we deal with this. So let's find inverse tangent of root 3 over 3. So the first thing I notice is that, okay, we're looking for the output of an inverse tangent function. So the output is some angle. Let's call it theta. Now what this implies, of course, is that tangent of the angle we're looking for is got to be root 3 over 3. Now, so I'm thinking to myself, oh, can I think of an angle such that tangent of that angle is root 3 over 3? Tangent is a little bit tricky. Now, we are interested in ratios involving the numbers like 1/2, and root 3 over 2, and then numbers like 0 and 1. And the reason I'm thinking of these numbers is because, remember, we like to think of tangent. We like to, generally, when working with tangent, we're thinking of the output as being y over x. So I want to, first of all, think about root 3 over 3. See, the problem is that I don't see the number 3 appearing here. I see root 3, but not 3 explicitly. So notice that, or recall from algebra, that if you take the square root of a and you divide it by a, well, a itself can be written as root a times root a. Right? And you can check that, right? Because root a times root a is a. Now, the point of doing that is that root a divided by root a, those cancel, and you have just 1 over root a. Now, that applies here, right? Because it's basically root 3 over 3, root 3 over 3, and that's equal to 1 over root 3. So this is equal to 1 over root 3. Now, the reason I did that is because I'm looking to regard this as y over x involving these numbers. So I can see that I can think of that 1, I can write that numerator rather as 1 half, and I can write that denominator as root 3 over 2. Now let me show you that this truly is that. So if I take 1 half and I divide it by the denominator, that's the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of the denominator, which is 2 over root 3, and the 2's would cancel, and lo and behold, I'd have 1 over root 3. So in other words, this is truly 1 over root 3. Now, why would I do that? That looks more complicated, because now I can regard the numerator as y and the denominator as x. So I'm thinking to myself, can I think of an angle theta such that tangent of that angle is 1 half divided by root 3 over 2? Oh, no problem. That's easy, right? Because that would be an angle I'm familiar with. That would be a 30 degree angle. So I know that tangent of 30 degrees is 1 half divided by root 3 over 2. And I know that because the y coordinate is 1 half and the x coordinate is root 3 over 2 when I have a unit circle. So what that's telling me is that the angle I'm interested in is pi over 6 in radians. Now, of course, the angle theta, that's what we're interested in, right? Because inverse tangent of root 3 over 3 is that angle. And that's why inverse tangent of root 3 over 3 is the angle pi over 6. Now, of course, you want the output to be between negative pi over 2 and positive pi over 2, right? That's the range of inverse tangent, and of course, pi over 6 satisfies that criteria. So this would be our result. Okay, so that takes us through almost all of the inverse functions. We still have inverse secant and inverse cosecant to talk about, and we'll do that in a future video. Until next time.